So, this is Lanzhou Station. I took this train this morning from Urumqi. It was a long ride, but it was a beautiful ride. Some beautiful views from the train. Really comfortable. I did it in a first class. Well, let's watch the video. I hope you enjoy it.
Well, my train is departing from Urumqi, but the day before that I arrived at the same station with a sleeper train from Kazakhstan. You can see this in my previous trip report. I took a taxi to this railway station since it was a kind of hard to find out how exactly I have to travel by public transport for my hotel. But the station is perfectly within reach of regular public transport. Urumqi is for China standards a small city. Well, to me it felt like a big city and there was still a lot of development going on. For example, here right at the railway station they were building lots of new skyscrapers. From this moment on, I'm pretty used to security at railway stations. You see it in Russia and Kazakhstan all the time. The security at this railway station took a little bit longer than I expected. This has to do with my first time in China experience. And, well, they took my cutlery and body spray and I had to drink some water to prove that my water wasn't something explosive. I wasn't really on time at the railway station as well. Well, because all of this, I had to run for my train and I couldn't do a station review. But I guess the layout of most high-speed railway stations in China is pretty much the same. Here you can see one of the trains where I'm on. I will take a better shot of the train where I'm on when I'm at the destination. The train where I'm on right now is based on the Pendolino trains. It's made by Alstom. You also find these types of trains on many European routes, for example the Eurocity trains between Frankfurt, Basel and Milan, but also many Frecciargento trains. But the layout is completely different in the Chinese trains. I'll show you in a bit. When you leave the city like this, you can see how huge the development is that's going on in China. It's not only here, but in many places in China they're building completely new cities and neighborhoods. In a lot of these newly built neighborhoods or cities, it felt like there was living nobody. They were pretty much empty, the houses, or at least that's how it looked like for me. Your ticket will be checked when you enter the station, if you have a valid ticket, before you enter the platform, if you enter the right train, and in the train to see if you're on the right spot. I'll be traveling first class on this route. This train has only one first class carriage. First class comes in a 2x2 configuration, which basically means you have two seats on both sides of the aisle. Seats can be reclined and there's so much leg space you won't bother the person who is behind you. The person in front of me reclined his seat and I still have lots of space. And I'm a big boy, I'm 1m90 or 6.23 feet tall. And of course, you will find a footrest as well, like you can see here. In the armrest you will find an entertainment system, although it didn't look like this was on. Another thing you will find in the armrest is a fold-out table. Apart from this, there's lots of space in the windowsill. It's almost like an extra table. And some train information is provided as well. Although it says passenger service information, the book itself was only in Chinese. Under your own seat and in front of your own seat, you will find a power plug. There are coat hangers. Here, like in many Asian trains, the chairs are put in driving position, which means you have some extra luggage space behind the last row. Of course, you find luggage space at the regular places as well, like the overhead racks and at the end of the compartment. Just like in pretty much every Chinese train, you can tap hot water for free. Of course, there are toilets in this train and they include a sink, but apart from that, there's also a sink at many places at the balcony. When someone who's just as white as I am, or, well, when the sun is just really bright, you can put the sunscreen down to, well, protect your eyes. Most of the toilets in this train are Western style, but you can find some of non-Western style toilets as well. All the toilets and, well, the train in general was kept pretty clean during the way. The cleaning lady was wiping the floor pretty often and she came also by pretty often with a trolley to collect garbage. Another trolley came by pretty often to sell some food and drinks. This way the cleaning lady could be guaranteed that she had enough garbage to collect again in her trolley. And yes, I am being sarcastic right now. The second class comes in a 2x3 configuration, which means two seats on one side of the aisle and three on the other side. You still have lots of leg space. And the power plug can be found at exactly the same spot as in the first class. The second class seats are also always facing forward, so you have some extra luggage space at the end of the last row. And of course, there's lots of luggage space at the overhead racks and at the end of each compartment. You won't find a restaurant in this train, but there is a kind of kiosk. Seat numbers look to be very standardized in Chinese trains. Here you have A window, B middle and C aisle, but it may be confusing sometimes as well, because on the other side of the second class there is no E. The first class has a 2x2 configuration, so the middle seats, the B and the E, are not mentioned here. So A and C and D and F are in first class next to each other. Train announcements are made in Uyghur, English and Chinese, but the conductor also calls people when they are at the station. Of course, the train makes several stops along the way. Most of these stops were just really quick. The train only held there for, well, maybe less than a minute. I'll be taking other high-speed trains as well, and those trains do make longer stops at railway stations. For some of these stations, it felt like they were built literally in the middle of nowhere. Well, this is China, so who knows, when I come back in 5 years, there might be an entire city around this station. This train is running along the Lanzhou-Xinyang high-speed railway line. It's also known as the Lanzhou-Xinyang Passenger Railway or the Lanxing Second Railway. I can get into a lot of details about this railway line, but I will save you from that. What is absolutely worth mentioning is that this railway line is, from a technical point of view, pretty awesome. It's been built to cope with extreme weather conditions, with hot summers and really cold winters. Another difficulty for this railway line is that it can be very windy in this area. So just like many high-speed lines, you will find lots of windshields here. But what's the great thing about these windshields is that you can actually look a little bit through them, so you can still enjoy the view. The high-speed line has been built next to the conventional railway line. On many parts of the route, the non-high-speed trains do share the same track with the high-speed trains. This only counts for passenger trains. Freight trains that will travel along the Silk Road to Europe, for example, will take the conventional railway line, and this is a lot slower. Because both Urumqi and Lanzhou are relatively small cities for China standards, and there are only 4 high-speed trains between this city that will do the entire route per day, in both directions of course, there is some extra capacity left for, well, non-high-speed passenger trains. Comparing to conventional railway lines, high-speed lines go on a straight line, so this also saves some travel time when you travel on conventional trains. One of the things that was really bothering me during this trip was the presence of some cops that were screaming more or less the same message throughout the carriage between all the stations. Well, I don't mind safety, but this kind of safety doesn't make any sense to me. They were not even looking at people, they were just looking straight forward. One of them had a megaphone and at the end he had to use it, of course. This is a kind of hard to explain and it's a pity I didn't put it on camera. Like I mentioned in the beginning of this video, the views from the train are pretty awesome and also really diverse. I will just let you see some views I had from the train and I will do it in order. In the evening, the train is reaching its final destination, Lanzhou West Station. also known as Lanzhou Qi. My next train departs from here and I will do a station review in my next trip report about this station. As always, give me a thumbs up when you like this video and subscribe to my channel when you'd like to see more trip reports. See you in my next trip report, which will be from Lanzhou to Beijing.